"If you please, Miss Minchin," said Sarah suddenly, "mayn't Becky stay?" It was a bold thing to do. Miss Minchin was betrayed into something like a slight jump. Then she put her eyeglass up and gazed at her show pupil disturbedly. "Becky!" she exclaimed. "My dearest Sarah!" Sarah advanced a step toward her.
"I want her because I know she will like to see the presents," she explained. "She is a little girl too, you know."
Miss Minchin was scandalized. She glanced from one figure to the other.
"My dear Sarah," she said, "Becky is the scullery maid. Scullery maids are not little girls."
It really had not occurred to her to think of them in that light. Scullery maids were machines who carried coal scuttles and made fires.
"But Becky is," said Sarah, "and I know she would enjoy herself. Please let her stay, because it is my birthday."
Miss Minchin replied with much dignity,
"As you ask it as a birthday favour, she may stay. Rebecca, thank Miss Sarah for her great kindness."
Becky had been backing into the corner, twisting the hem of her apron in delighted suspense. She came forward, bobbing curtsies, but between Sarah's eyes and her own there passed a gleam of friendly understanding while her words tumbled over each other.
"Oh, if you please, miss, I'm that grateful, miss. I did want to see the doll, miss, that I did. Thank you, miss. And thank you, mum,"
turning and making an alarmed bob to Miss Minchin,
"for letting me take the liberty."
Miss Minchin waved her hand again. This time it was in the direction of the corner near the door.
"Go and stand there," she commanded. "Not too near the young ladies."
Becky went to her place, grinning. She did not care where she was sent, so that she might have the luck of being inside the room instead of being downstairs in the scullery while these delights were going on.